Hey guys, just Missouri Mike again, out here hunting. It's early this morning. It's already gotten hot. I kind of overslept a little bit. I was planning on being here at 6:30. I got here at 7:45, so it's already heating up. Missouri. Kind of showing you the house I'm hunting here. It's a old abandoned house boarded up. The property owner told me they weren't going to mow the yard again, so I've got to get in here and get this done before the grass gets so high I can't hunt. I'll show you this. I got this yesterday. It's one of these cooling things for you guys that are out in the heat hunting. I tried it out and working in the garden a little bit yesterday, and it really worked. It really did. It surprised me. It just goes around your neck and you put a little water on it and stretch it. And they're not cheap, but if it can make your day go a lot easier, it's probably worth the effort. You don't have to use it metal tech, and you can use it doing anything else you want. Lots of different ways you can put on your head to cool your head off, and that cools you down, and it does work. So I'm not advertising for this company. It's just something you might think about if you're out in the heat hunting. So, well, I'm gonna get to it. I'm gonna hunt over in this area by this tree over here. I hadn't hunted yet over there in that area there. So anyway, we'll see what happens. I brought me a new digger. Got me a sharp little shovel today. Just maybe we can get some of them roots. All right. Well, there's a good sign for the day. First dig of the day. Awesome. Piece of good pull tab junk. All right. Keeping it real. It did rain a little bit last night, so this ground's not quite as dry as it's been, but it won't take long for it to dry back out. So, see what's been fine. Well, I just dug this little plate jewelry heart, purple. It's kind of cool. On to the next one. Well, I just dug this thing, and I don't know what it is. I think it's a lipstick thing, maybe, but I've never seen one like this before. It's looks like it's painted, old lead paint. It's silver on the end. Looks like it maybe got a hinge spot on it. So I don't know if it's a lipstick thing or what it is, actually. It's not silver or anything. But it came up as a high tone. But it was down about 5 inches, so I think it's been fairly deep down here. This front yard where I'm at here may have been filled at one time. It's higher than the rest of the yard. And I hate that. A lot of times if you look at a yard, you can read the yard just by the way the grass looks. The newer grass look different than the older grass. A lot of the older grass is pretty weak grass, but this new grass in here, and then of course it's higher if they fill it. You can tell a lot of times, just look at the yard in different areas and see. Usually the front yards get filled, the backyards don't get messed with unless it's a drainage problem. But I think this front yard's been filled, so, but you never know. There's a new tree in the front yard, fairly new. Doesn't dictate the age of the house, but not a big oak tree or anything like that, so this may have been filled at one time. We'll go on and see what else we can find. Keeping it real. Okay guys, I'm gonna try to do a live dig here. It's gonna be kind of hard because I think this item's fairly deep. So here it goes. Yeah, this isn't gonna work out very good. Let's see if I can kind of do it this way here. Alright. Yeah, I think this is fairly deep, whatever it is. I have kind of a bouncy signal. It's bouncing on the machine around 91, 88, but it sounds deep. There's lots of roots there. Roll the plug out hole. This ground, even though it rained, is still super, super, super dry. Lots of roots in here, too. Hopefully it's something decent, but it may just be junk.
Well, it's still down there. Down about probably 8-10 inches now. Where did it go? Pin pointer turned off for some reason. Oh, it's out of the hole. There it is. It is a penny. What sucker was deep? It better be a wheat, deep as it was. And it is. All right. Live dig, got a wheat. I was hoping for a silver, but I can't complain. I can't quite read the date on it. My eyes are just so bad anymore. But it's in good shape. The thing was down there. It's down there at the bottom of that plug, at the very bottom of that hole. I popped it out, so it was at least 7 to 8 inches deep. So, anyway, I'll go on to the next one. Got me another wheat. It was down only about 3 inches or so, but it had a funny signal. It was up against a bunch of roots and stuff. Looks pretty toasty. I'll have to clean that one up when I get home. It's got a little green tint to it. It may be fairly old, but it wasn't real deep. This yard's been moved before. I don't know if it's been filled or just been moved around, but anyway, that's a good sign. I'm hunting around this old maple tree in the front. It's not real old, but them roots have a tendency to push that stuff up, you know. So it may have been deeper at one time and got forced to the surface, but all right, it's starting to warm up a little bit. Been here about an hour, hour and a half, so we'll see what we can take the rest of the morning. Well, I just pulled my third wheat here, so it's looking promising. Hopefully there'll be a silver come up here shortly. Pretty excited about it. This signal here on this machine, on this deuce machine, it came up really strange. I think there's a lot of junk around it, and I had to kind of pull it out of the junk. But it's down about 5.5-6 inches maybe. It was down there at the bottom of that plug, so. All right, on to the next one. I'm just gonna show you on that last hole with that wheat penny. This was right in there with it, just right up against the side of the plug edge. And a lot of times those signals will be, they'll be there, but then they don't want to stay in the machine because this will cancel that other reading out. And a lot of coins get missed that way. They just don't hit good in the machine. So, you know, you got to really pay attention to what your ears tell you and kind of look at your reading on your meter. And you're going to dig a lot of this kind of junk though, but you will find some stuff in with it. You will do that. Well, it's got me another wheat. I'll tell you what, this one was a tough one to dig. It was down there in them roots. It wasn't very deep, but my gosh, it was just packed in there with them roots and stuff. It growed in between 2 or 3 in that hole there. But I'd say it wasn't very deep. It's pretty tarnished. I'll have to wait till I get home to do a cleanup on it. So far I've not really found any relics here. Nice relic stuff. So I have started to find a few wheat, so that's my fourth one so far. So maybe there'll be a silver pop up here. All right, it's getting about 10 o'clock. Probably another good little breeze, though, a little cloud cover. I might be able to make it till noon today. On to the next one. Well, I'm gonna live dig this one. I think the ground missed that root there. So I think I can maybe get in there and get this one out. I just can't believe how many little roots is in there. It's unreal. I think that's one reason why them coins. There it is. Popped out right there. See it? Right there it is. That's why a lot of these coins ain't real deep. Them roots has kept them from going deep. Another week. Awesome. And I'll have to clean up. This has got good green tone to it here. You can see the edges are green. I think that may be a really good one. All right, need to find an Indian head or a silver now. Finding a lot of weeds. Got this old tree, they've got these coins worked up right in here. That's awesome. They're not very deep. That one was only about 2.5 inches deep, maybe. Had a good signal. Come in 88 on the deuce machine. All right, on to the next one. Got another wheat. This one here, there was a nail in the hole also. I'll have to clean it up and see what it is, but I'm gonna check this hole because the reading I got was one of like high silver. Not high hole silver, but high silver, but that was weird. That nail must have been reacting with that coin because that's all it's in there. All right, on to the next one. Got another wheat here. This one's down in them roots there. It's probably 5 inches down there underneath that bottom root, and I flipped it out. And I had a nail in the hole with this one. It's pretty beat up, so we'll see how old it is when I do the cleanup. On to the next one. Alright guys, I'm going to dig this one live. It came up as a 9091 on my machine. I think I'm going to try to dig. Well, I just can't believe the roots in this yard. I mean, it's unreal. A lot of stuff here is not very deep. I just can't believe how bad these roots are, though. I think the mosquitoes are out, too. Got that rain kind of activated then. It's a little bit cool this morning. Get that mosquito. Damn. Unbelievable. Yep. There it is. All right. Piece of junk. Pretty cool, whatever it is, though. Don't even see it or not. It's green. It's got copper to it. Pretty cool relic. Top off something. It's copper. Wow. It's a pretty good find. I don't know if it's valuable or not. Probably not, but it's pretty neat. It's heavy. It's not lead, though. I believe it's copper. It's not a coin. I'll have to dig that, clean that up. It came up with a high tone. I scratched it a little bit right there. Like I say, it's not a coin, but it's got a lot of green tint to it, like it's copper. Put some water on it here. Oh, it's got a neat design on it, whatever it is. All right. Yep, on to the next one. I just dug this Missouri sales tax receipt token. It's 5. Usually the ones I dig are 1s, but this one's got a 5 on it. It's been shot with a 22, it looks like. on the right side. I don't know about that hole in the middle. It's pretty neat. This is in good shape. It really is. That'll clean up nice. But it's got a 5 on the left, so it's not a 1 cent sales tax token. It's a 5. And that's in good shape. It really is. So I'm pretty proud of that. That's pretty neat. All right, so on to the next one, guys. On to the next one. Okay, guys, my battery's starting to get a little weak, but I'm going to try to do this. I'm going to show you on my machine. I don't know if you can see that or not. I've got a pretty good reading here. A dang glare. '88, '92, '91. Pretty much means with this machine, it's a Deus machine with a small coil, that it's probably something good. It stayed in the machine good. It didn't kick out. It shows it to be about 6 inches deep, but it's of course in right where there's a root. And I'm telling you what, this yard's the hardest yard I've ever dug in my life. As far as roots, grass roots, it's unreal how thick they are here. But this came up good, and my dang recorders, I'm about to get a new battery. It's flashing red. Let me get this out of the hole and then I'll get right back with you, okay? All right, guys. I'm back, and I got a silver. I just wanted to show you, that was that hole. 91, 92 on this Deus machine, and it's gonna be silver. And it looks like it's probably, see what it is here, it's gonna be a mercury. Yes, sir. All right, baby, yeah. Gotta love it, man. I'm not gonna clean it off. It's pretty corroded there on top. I don't want to scratch it anymore than I have to, but I can see the wreath on the back. I am super stoked on this, man. Gotta love it. Gotta love this hunting. Oh yeah. I don't find a lot of silver, so I get excited. I'm a little excited right now. I'm gonna put it in my secret spot and clean it up later. My battery's getting flashing red here, so I'm not got a lot of time left. That thing was down in this root right here, and like I say, this yard is unbelievably rooty. Worst yard I ever seen to dig. Nothing's real deep, not super deep, but I mean 6-7 inches, but nothing deeper than that. But I'm telling you, it's awesome. Yep. Boy, I wished I could have done that live. Dang battery's flashing red. I just didn't want to take a chance on going out on me. I got a little bit of battery life left here. Probably enough for another shot or two, maybe. All right, I'll keep going. I believe this might be a silver coin here. I'm going to try to dig it live. I don't know if my battery will last or not, but hopefully. There it is. Oh, no. Boy, I got hammered on that one. Building back memorial. Wow, I got burned on that call, didn't I? Oh well, make sure there's nothing up in there. Nope, that was it. For some reason, it didn't come up as a real high reading, but it's definitely a building back. All right, on to the next one. Keeping it real. I'm going to show you this little bitty grommet right here off a shoelace, probably off a tennis shoe. Only about an inch down. But stuff like that mixed in with the coin will drive you crazy. It's definitely junk, but just little bitty stuff like that, it's hard to pinpoint, hard to find, and takes you a while to get it, and it can actually mess up a good reading. So I've got a good reading in here beside this, I think. see if I can find it. Guys, I'm going to make this probably my last dig here. My battery's just about out, and it's getting around noontime. I've got right there where that deal is, there's the top of the root, and right there where I started my dig is right along the edge. So I'm going to turn this off and see if I can find what's in there. I'll get back with you shortly. I think it may be a silver coin, I'm not sure. Alright, well, I'm going to dig this until my battery gets dead. I think it's right in there, right along the edge of that root there. I hear it buzzing, boy, it's up underneath that root. Right in that V spot there. I don't know if I've got enough power to get this. It's my last hole. I dug this nice ring. It was in with another band thing. My battery's going dead, but it was in with this little necklace thing. And the necklace thing was all tore off, and this was around it, like somebody was wearing it around their neck. And I don't know if it's gold, but I know it's definitely silver. Sure looks like it's silver. It could be gold, though, too. But it's really neat. Neat-looking ring. My last dig for this morning's hunt. So, I'll show you what else was in there if I can find it. It was this thing right here. This right here was in the hole also. And that's a wire loop thingy, I guess, and that was in with the... Alright guys, this is Mike. Gonna do a little clean out here, or clean up, I guess. Gonna kinda go through what I found. I got out there, and it was Saturday morning, and it was early, and I didn't get out quite as early as I wanted to. I got there around 8 or so, and I had until a little longer than I wanted. I got a little warm there, and until about 12:30 or so. So I had about four and a half hours of this. I didn't do that well on the coins. I didn't find the amount that, you know, I wanted. But what I did find was a little bit strange. I found more wheats today than I've ever found versus the zinc pennies that are there versus the copper pennies and the other stuff. I did get a good silver today. And I got a pretty cool token. So let me go through these. These coins... on all the wheats, they range in date from 1941 being the oldest to 58. I got a 44S, 50D, 42D, 58D, 45D, 44. Come over here. I got a 55 again, a 41D. A 44D, and a 5060. Now, all those coins are in fairly good shape. There's not any of them that are really wore out. Now, right next to this house that I was hunting, there was a vacant lot. That's where I pulled the 1913 Barber and the older 1918 Wheat. So there must have been a house or another building there previous next door, because this yard seems to be... just give up stuff around in the World War II era time in the 40s and things. 44 Mercury.